We have some honored guests here tonight. Representative Matt Hudson, please come forward. You had a long drive to come here. I know that drive.
Hey, good evening. It's always a pleasure to be at BREC, but this is kind of a special evening because I haven't had a chance to just say thank you from the last election. You know, it's kind of an interesting thing when you represent both coasts to see the dynamics between the turnout. And when I first ran for election in 2007, virtually no one knew me in Broward County. I didn't have the support of most of the Republican clubs. I was certainly the odd man out on the primaries. And quite frankly, the only person I knew in Broward County was my ex-wife. I don't want to go on a limb or anything, but I feel fairly confident I was not going to get her vote. And since then, what a transition it's been. And the embrace I've gotten from Broward County has been just overwhelming. And for that, I'm very, very thankful. And I've tried to be very participatory, not only in BREC, but in other community events. In fact, I was with Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital Saturday, got to umpire the Legends game, which was kind of fun, and volunteered for them. But I like to make sure that I'm engaged. And this year, the election results were pretty special. In a district that is 2-1 Democrat to Republican in Broward County, I got 57% of the vote. I can tell you that is in no small part to the efforts of a lot of people in this room. And I'm sure if I tried to rattle them off, I'd miss some folks. But there's people in this room that held fundraisers at their home for me, that went out and walked for me, that lent their name and support for me, that made phone calls for me, that manned the victory office out in Miramar, and just really worked hard to make sure that we have one central goal. We've got to get Republicans elected in Broward County. And for your efforts and my efforts to see those returns was phenomenal. And so for me to you, just thank you very much for all the hard work that you've done. We've got a lot of work to do, but I'll tell you what, the future is bright. We've got a super majority in the Florida House. We've got a super majority in the Florida Senate. We own the cabinet, and we finally have a governor again. So there's a lot of positive things that are going on. Senator Bogdanoff and I are going to be working on legislation together on a couple of different issues this year and continue where we've worked in the past. I was fortunate enough to be named Chair of Healthcare Appropriations. Congratulations, your chair. Condolences, your chair. Kind of comes out in the same sentence that way. But we've got a lot of interesting decisions to make this year. And we're going to work very hard with our governor. The governor started releasing some of his budget today, and we'll continue to do so tomorrow on through the 7th. And we'll look at his proposals because we want to see a good victory for him and his office. We want to see a good win for the Republican-dominated legislature. But more importantly than that, we want to see a good win for the Floridians and taxpayers of the state of Florida. Because I know when we put our heads together, we are absolutely going to see the right sizing of government. We're going to see a tremendous decrease in spending, and more importantly, we're going to be a more leaner, meaner, responsive government than you have ever seen before, and I look forward to that. And so thank you very much.